Hello, very good day, guys. So, till now we have seen in the normal megacellis, the anterior part, very simple, very small and very quick. Now, the very larger part of the normal basalis, okay, very the howa, very horrible you say, but if you see this through this 3D diagram and all this thing in front of your eyes, okay, it inside go through the, your eyes, it is going in your brain and the nervous system and it will get stuck. I'm very confident about you because you all guys are very awesome, very intelligent, okay, and very happy and very peaceful, right? So I know you will grasp it very quickly, there is no doubt, okay? You are the meritorious, so just remain with me, just concentrate on all the structures and the name I am telling you and revive it after this from your books, whatever you are referring, and you will get very pakka in your mind about this, all the structure of the normal basalis in the middle part, okay? And you'll be the master of the master. Chalo, I'm giving you a guarantee, okay? So you are ready now, okay? So we'll start. So middle part of the normal basalis, so it extends from, as we have seen in the last video, it extends from the posterior border of the hard palate here up to the transverse line, that is arbitrary imaginary line passing through the anterior margin of the foramen magnum. So again, this normal basalis is very large and very howa. So now we will make ourselves convenience for this by dividing it into the median area and the lateral area. So we'll see what is the structure present in this median area of the normal basalis. Okay, so guys, you are ready? Very good. So the median area shows a posterior border of the omer. So you can see this omerine bone. The posterior border of the omer is present here. Then there is a broad bar of the bone formed by the fusion of the posterior part of the body of the sphenoid bone and basilar part of the occipital bone. So yahan se basilar part of the occipital bone aur aage se posterior part of the body of the sphenoid. So they are together forming the broad bar of the bone. Very good. Then further, the omer separates the two posterior nasal apertures. So we have seen the anterior nasal aperture in the norma frontalis. Now you can see the posterior nasal aperture in this norma basalis separated by the omer into two posterior nares. Right? So its inferior border articulates with the bony palate. The hard palate dekha na? So upper surface pe it, all these are articulating with the lower border of the omer. The superior border of the omer bone, it splits into two ali and articulates with the rostrum of the sphenoid bone. So anteroinferior surface of the body of the sphenoid bone is having a anteroposterior linear elevation that is known as the rostrum. So this rostrum is get sandwiched between the two split projections known as the ala of the omer bone. Samajh mein aaya? And this joint is known, it is also the sutural type of the joint, that is syndalysis. If you heard about the or read about the syndalysis, the fifth type of the suture, most of the places it is written syndalysis. So this is the syndalysis between the rostrum of the sphenoid bone and the ala of the omer. Got it? Okay, further. So next, there is the palatovaginal canal and umerovaginal canal. So they are very fine structure to show here, but I will try to show. And you just go to your books and read about that. See the diagram over there. So the palatovaginal canal means this is the inferior surface. The inferior surface of the vaginal process of the medial pterygoid plate. This is the medial pterygoid plate, you can see. This is pterygoid process, this is lateral plate, and this is the medial pterygoid plate. The medial pterygoid plate is having a vaginal process medially. Okay, and this is marked by the anteroposterior groove, which is converted into the palatovaginal canal by the upper surface of the sphenoid process of palatine bone. Palatine bone ka kaun sa process? Which process? The sphenoidal process. From the medial and from the lateral is coming the vaginal process of medial pterygoid plate. And these two are together forming the palatovaginal canal. So that is from the palatine bone and the medial pterygoid plate are coming the palatovaginal canal, simply. The canal opens anteriorly into the posterior wall of the pterygopalatine fossa. If you remember, infratemporal fossa of the norma lateralis, I have shown you the pterygomaxillary fissure and entering into the pterygopalatine fossa. So that pterygopalatine fossa ka jo posterior wall hai, wahan pe jaake open hota hai, this opens the palatovaginal canal, opens into that wall of the pterygopalatine fossa. Simple. Then the second one is the umerovaginal canal. So what is the umerovaginal canal? The lateral border of each ala of the umer comes into relationship with the vaginal process of the medial pterygoid plate and may overlap it from about to enclose the umerovaginal canal. Got it, guys? So again, here the vaginal process of the medial pterygoid plate articulating with the lateral border of ala of umer. So that is the umerovaginal canal, and it is inconstant, not always present. Fine. Then, so all we have seen these two canals. Now we'll see the broad bar of the bone, which is marked in median plane by pharyngeal tubercle. So broad bar we have seen. So it is having in its median portion the tubercle, the elevation, and that is known as the pharyngeal tubercle, which is little in front of the. You can see that this pharyngeal tubercle is a little in front of the foramen magnum, right? So we have completed this median area. Now lateral area. This is more larger, right? Okay. We'll start and we will grasp it. I am very confident about it. Okay. So the lateral area shows two parts of the sphenoid bone. That is, one is the pterygoid process and the greater ring, and three parts of the temporal bone. That is petrous temporal bone we can see here. The tympanic plate we can see here. And the squamous part of the temporal bone. Aaga samajh mein? So pterygoid process with the greater wing and the petrous temporal tympanic plate and the squamous part of the temporal bone. Now we'll see first the pterygoid process. So this project downwards from the junction of the greater wing and the body of the sphenoid bone behind the third molar tooth. You can see this third molar tooth. So behind that it projecting downwards. And inferiorly, it divides into the medial and the lateral pterygoid plate, which are fused together anteriorly, but are separated posteriorly by a V-shaped fossa known as the pterygoid fossa. So this is the pterygoid fossa we can see, directed posteriorly, and the fused anterior border of the two plates articulates medially with the perpendicular plate of the palatine bone. Okay, perpendicular plate of the palatine bone. And are separated laterally from the posterior surface of the body of the mandibula by pterygomaxillary fissure. So you can see this is the pterygomaxillary fissure between the mandibula and the pterygoid process. Got it? And then you will enter through it into the pterygopalatine fossa. चलो अभी मिडिल टेरिगोइड प्लेट देखते हैं फटाफट. तो मिडिल टेरिगोइड प्लेट इज डायरेक्टेड बैकवर्ड. इट हैज मिडियल एंड द लैटरल सर्फेस. Medial and lateral surfaces and the pre-posterior border. The upper end of this border divides to enclose a triangular depression which is called a scaphoid fossa. Scaphoid fossa. Scaphoid means boat. Triangular means boat shape or scaphoid fossa. Medial to this fossa there is a small pterygoid tubercle. What is that? Pterygoid tubercle which projects into foramen lacerum. This is the foramen lacerum you can see. Lacerated margin, therefore foramen lacerum. It hides from view of the posterior opening of the pterygoid canal. So there is a pterygoid canal in anterior wall of this foramen lacerum which is being hidden by this pterygoid tubercle. Okay. Then the lower end of the posterior border is prolonged downwards and laterally to form a pterygoid hamulus. Okay, so this is the pterygoid hamulus here. So almost most of the time it gets broken when we handle it, otherwise it is present. Very important structure it is also. Now the lateral pterygoid plate. So lateral pterygoid plate is directed backwards and laterally. So it has a medial and the lateral surfaces again and a pre posterior border again. The lateral surface forms the medial wall of the infratemporal fossa. This is the infratemporal fossa you can see, medial to the ramus of the mandible, and the medial wall is formed by the lateral surface of the lateral pterygoid plate. No confusion, you are good, you are intelligent. Okay, now the medial surface gives origin to the muscle, and the posterior border sometimes has a projection called as the pterygospinous process, which projects toward the spine of the sphenoid bone. Got it? The posterior border sometimes has a projection known as the pterygospinous process, projecting toward the spine of the sphenoid. So this is the spine of the sphenoid, you can see, and this is the pterygospinous process. Okay guys, now the infratemporal surface, now here you can see infratemporal surface of the greater wing of the sphenoid bone, which is pentagonal. If you can lineate it, you can find this is pentagonal in shape. So its anterior margin forms the posterior border of inferior orbital fissure. You can see this is the inferior orbital fissure here. If you can see it from the orbit, the superior orbital fissure and inferior orbital fissure. So inferior margin of this anterior margin of this posterior border of the inferior orbital fissure is here. Then its anterolateral margin forms the infratemporal crest. Okay? This is known as the infratemporal crest. Then its posterolateral margin articulates with the squamous part of the temporal bone. ठीक है, यहाँ पे तुमको दिख रहा है, दिस इज द मैंडिबुलर फोसा फॉर आर्टिकुलेशन विद द हेड ऑफ द मैंडिबल फॉर टेम्पोरो मैंडिबुलर जॉइंट. तो दिस इज द पोस्टरोलैटरल मार्जिन ऑफ इंफ्राटेम्पोरल सरफेस ऑफ द ग्रेटर विंग ऑफ द स्पिनॉइड बोन. इट पोस्टरोमीडियल मार्जिन आर्टिकुलेट्स विद द पेट्रस पार्ट ऑफ द टेम्पोरल बोन, एंड एंट्रोमीडियली इट इज कंटिन्यूअस विद द टेरिगॉइड प्रोसेस इंफीरियरली विद द बॉडी ऑफ द स्पिनॉइड बोन. So these were about the margins of the infratemporal surface. Now the posterior most point between the posterolateral and the posteromedial margin projects downward to form the spine of the sphenoid. Just few moments I have told you about this. This is the spine of the sphenoid. You can see it clearly here. Okay? Very good. Now along the posteromedial margin, the surface is pierced by these foramina, you can see in line posterolaterally. So first one, this is the foramen oval, which is large and oval in shape, as the name suggests. It is situated posterolateral to the upper end of the posterior border of lateral pterygoid plate. Okay? Then posterolateral to this is the foramen sphenoidum, which is small and circular in shape, and it is situated posterolateral to the foramen oval and is limited posterolaterally by the spine of the sphenoid. Therefore, it is known as the foramen sphenoidum, obviously. Then, sometimes there is a emissary sphenoidal foramen or foramen of Vesalius. It is situated between foramen oval and foramen, the sphenoid fossa, scaphoid fossa. Okay? And internally, it opens between the foramen oval and the foramen rotundum. Foramen rotundum is present in the middle cranial fossa, not on this norma basalis. Then at times there is a canaliculus innominatus situated or located between the foramen oval and the foramen sphenoidum. What is that? Canaliculus innominatus. It is occasional. Now the spine of the sphenoid may be sharply pointed or blunt. The spine of the sphenoid may be sharply pointed or blunt. The sulcus tubae is there, which is a groove between the posteromedial margin of the greater wing of the sphenoid and petrous part of the temporal bone, and it lodges the cartilaginous part of the auditory tube or eustachian tube between the lateral wall of the nose and middle ear or tympanic cavity, right? And posteriorly the groove leads to the bony part of the auditory tube, which lies within the petrous temporal bone. Okay, then the inferior surface of the petrous part of the temporal bone we can see here. So it is triangular in shape and it affects directed toward forwards and the medially, and it lies between the greater wing of the sphenoid bone and here medially the base occiput. Its apex is perforated by the upper end of the carotid canal. Remember, carotid canal. And it is separated from the sphenoid by a gap that is known as the foramen lacerum, between the body of the sphenoid and apex of the petrous temporal bone is foramen lacerum. and the inferior surface is perforated by the lower end of the carotid canal. So here is the lower end of the carotid canal on the inferior surface, and on the apex there is the upper opening end of the carotid canal. Okay, so carotid canal is finally opening into the foramen lacerum. Got it? Very good. Then the carotid canal runs forward and medially within the petrous temporal bone. So this whole petrous temporal bone is cannulated by the canal known as the carotid canal, which is containing transmitting the internal carotid artery along with its sympathetic plexus of the nerve. Okay guys, so you have received grasped all these things. Now this is the foramen lacerum, which is short wide canal 1 centimeter long, and its lower end is bounded posterolaterally by the apex of the petrous temporal bone, medially by the base of the foot and body of the sphenoid bone, and anteriorly by the root of the pterygoid process and the greater wing of the sphenoid bone. Okay, now a part of the petrous temporal bone which is called the tegment tympani is present in the middle cranial fossa. So it has a downturned edge here of the tegment tympani. So this downturned edge, which is seen in the squamotympanic fissure. Squamo means squamous part of temporal bone and tympani means tympanic part of temporal bone. So unke beech ka fissure ko bolte hain squamotympanic fissure. So you can see this partition in this this fissure. And this partition is nothing but it is a downturned edge of the tegment tympani. Got it? And it divides this squamotympanic features into posteriorly the prototympanic and anteriorly the petrotympanic, anteriorly the petrosquamous and posteriorly the petrotympanic fissures. Got it? Then, now the tympanic part of the temporal bone, that is also known as the tympanic plate. So it is a triangular curved plate which lies in angle between the petrous and the squamous part of the temporal bone. Its apex is directed medially and lies close to the spine of the sphenoid. The base or border is curved, free and roughened. Its anterior surface forms the posterior wall of the mandibular fossa, and the posterior surface is concave and forms the anterior wall floor and the lower part of the posterior wall of the bony external acoustic meatus. Which one? External acoustic meatus. And its upper border bound the petrotympanic fissures. This is the petrotympanic fissure, and the lower border is sharp and free. Medially it passes along the anterolateral margin of the lower end of the carotid canal. Okay? And laterally it forms the anterolateral part of the sheath of the stellate process. And internally the tympanic plate is fused to the petrous temporal bone. Okay, very broad, so just you have to read it once again later on and grasp it. Now the squamous part of the temporal bone forms the anterior part of the mandibular, also known as the articular fossa of the temporomandibular joint, which articulate with the head of the mandible to form TM joint, and the articular tubercle, which is continuous with the anterior root of the zygoma. This is the anterior root of the zygomatic arch, and a small posterolateral part of the roof of the infratemporal fossa. Got it? So this was all about the middle cranial. This is the middle portion, middle part of the norma basalis. Okay guys, so we have covered all this norma basalis. What are the structure passing through the foramina of all? So I will take a separate session after this, completing all this norma basalis. Okay, so guys, so we have done. You have done very good to be with me for this long session. So thank you very much, and all the best for your exams and the future career. Thank you very much. Bye bye.